Oh, look what we have here. A box from MSI and Intel. Okay, so we see the new motherboard, the B660M Mortar WIFI from MSI. Very interesting that this board, it is aimed at the entry to mid-range, but uses DDR5. I do hear that the DDR4 version may come up pretty soon. We wouldn't know, have to see what happens at CES in one more day. Oh, there's one more surprise below. Oh, such a nice felt box with the MSI Intel logo. And what's inside? Let's take a look. All right, thank you MSI Intel for passing me this Intel Core i5-12400. Let's do a very quick run through and benchmark of this new 12400. Is it a new worthy contender in the entry to mid-range? Let's find out. Okay, as this 12400 is still under NDA, I do not have much information about it. All I know is it's 6 cores and 12 threads. It only has performance cores and does not have efficiency cores. We have decided to pit it against its closest competitor, the AMD Ryzen 5 5600X. For test setups, we're going to put the new 12400 also on a new MSI B660M Mortar WiFi. Yes, I know this board uses DDR5 RAM, but I don't think there'll be a much performance boost when it comes to DDR5 versus DDR4. As for the 5600X, we'll use the very familiar MSI X570 Unify. Both the 12400 as well as the 5600X are cooled by 360mm AIOs, the EK360 for the blue side and the ML360 Illusion for the red side. Both setups will share the giant RTX 3080 Ti Supremax. To make this even more fair, we have turned on PBO for the red side. As for the blue side, we have set the water cooler so that there will be no power limits. I have also set XMP for both setups. And we'll be making use of resizable bar for the blue side as well as smart access memory for the red side. Okay, let's now go on to our gaming benchmarks. The first one, CSGO. On 1080p, the Intel 12400 scores an average of 570fps, losing against the AMD's 570. Also on 4040p, the Intel 12400 trails behind at 500fps against AMD Ryzen's 640fps. Okay, our second esports title, Rainbow Six Siege. At 1080p, the 12400 does 439 against the AMD Ryzen's 564. On 4040p, however, the 12400 wins the AMD Ryzen with 6 frames, 414 versus 408. Alright guys, for these next 2 games, welcome to my little benchmarking corner again. Gonna show you some gameplay footage, even though they are in-game benchmarks, of these 2 games. First game's Watch Dogs Legion. On the left, we have the Intel 12400 and on the right, the 5600X. Let's go! So, starting off, you can see that the 12400 has a slight lead at 100 plus FPS over the 5600X 90 FPS. This game running on Ultra, RTX and DLSS are off. 1080p for this one, forgot to mention, yeah. Okay, so since it's 1080p, it's more CPU bound. The 12400, 60-70% usage, 44 degrees, the 5600X also 60-70% usage and running 50 degrees. Pretty cool temperatures for both CPUs, especially the 12400. Very amazing. Elderly has outdone itself this time. 3080 Ti running at 90%+, nothing surprising. Watch Dogs Legion is a very, very graphical intensive game. So as we approach the later half of the benchmark, the 12400 is still at the lead, 100+ FPS and almost 100 FPS for the 5600X. Okay, the last game, of course, we have to include Cyberpunk 2077. This is our very famous taxi ride we always use for our benchmarks. Settings for these benchmarks are Ultra, RTX and DLSS are off. This benchmark is currently running at 1080p. Both CPUs are almost the same, 115-140 FPS. Cyberpunk 2077 is definitely a very GPU bound game. You can see even on 1080p, the GPU 3080 Ti is really running at almost 97%, 98%. 80%, 90% usage, quite intensive on the both CPU and GPU. Okay, one more thing, I've decided to throw in a very special someone, 12600K, 12400's older sibling. So you can see that the 12600K has a slight edge over both of them, not a lot, a few frames. The 12600K is definitely working less compared to both CPUs. The GPU is doing most of the job. Yeah, probably that's where the efficiency cost for the 12600K actually does it. Alright, similar to our 12600K video, let's go on to our favorite productivity benchmark, Cinebench R23. Nothing surprising here, the Intel 12400 wins the AMD Ryzen again with 12133 versus 11564. This is very interesting. both the 5600X and the 1200 are 6 cores and 12 threads. And assuming that both have the same stock clock as well as the max boost clock, why does the 5600X lose to the 1200? My guess is, does the 1200 have a higher IPC than the 5600X? And if you're wondering how hot are these three CPUs doing idle and load, here are the numbers. Okay guys, so what do I think about this new Intel 1400? For an entry to mid-range option, this CPU is pretty good, even for a non-case CPU. Very good performance for first-person shooter games, giving you awesome FPS numbers for CSGO as well as Rainbow Six Siege. For Cyberpunk 2077 and Legion, because they are more GPU-bound, Intel 1400 still performs pretty good in these AAA titles. However, as a caveat, in a previous video, the 12600K video, which was paired with Z690, we kinda wish that there was a B660 motherboard which uses DDR4 RAM. But alas, this B660M Mortar WIFI uses only DDR5. As you guys may know, DDR5 RAM right now is either too expensive or basically cannot be found. Until the point where it's a B660M Mortar which uses DDR4 RAM, I feel that the Intel 12th Gen ecosystem right now is not so compelling for you to enter. On the other hand, on the red side, you can easily save money by buying a B550M Mortar WIFI paired with this 5600X. AMD's ecosystem right now is definitely better for you to enter. Getting out of the entire PC ecosystem between the 12400 and the 12600K, the 12400 is definitely cheaper, but you do lose out on gaming performance for games such as Rainbow Six Siege, which loves higher IPC, higher core count, especially at 1080p. The 12600K's added 500MHz in clock speed gives it an added edge over the 1200 in gaming. Other games such as Watch Dogs Legion and Cyberpunk 2077 is even matched between these two CPUs. But besides being affordable, the 12400 has another advantage. You can just use an air cooler and your 12400 will run just fine. You do not need to spend extra money to buy a 240 or 360 rack AIO. Okay, to sum it all up, the 5600X is definitely more affordable now in terms of the entire PC ecosystem. Between the 12400 and the 12600K, if you need more performance, go for the 12600K. But if you are good with regular performance, and since the 12400 does pretty well at 1080p, go for the 12400. Although, you should take note that 2 or 3 years down the road, when there's new GPUs coming out, your 1200 may become a bottleneck for your PC. So, with that, if you like my review of this Core i5 1200, make sure to smash the like button. And in the meantime, if you've not watched our review of the 12600K, you can do so in the video below. And make sure to smash the subscribe button because we are going to do a discussion between a K and a non-K CPU. If you don't want to mix that, make sure to come back to our channel. See you in the next tech episode, and thank you.